But we're gonna get it started, man. Comments are rolling. All right, Danielle, relax, man. I know she said a little something.
God. Hey, Danielle.
Alex gonna be able to fit through the door in her bathroom. She's gonna have to turn silent. Big as shit. All right. Last topic of the evening. Let me share one more comment. I'll let Sinead get her lick back. Okay. All right. Last topic for the evening. Let me get to it. All right. Kind of goes back to the first topic, I think. First topic. Now, obviously, you know, we know this is Ciara. She's a married woman. Once again, twerking with a bottle on her head and no shirt on. The married woman twerking, like, that's a, like Isha said, this is just some normal shit that just going on. Is this acceptable? Should a married woman, or even lower than that, should a married woman or a woman in a relationship be twerking for the gram or twerking in public or twerking for attention, not on her husband very specifically? Aisha, what's your thoughts?
Like I said, it's a cultural norm. What I do, I think is disrespectful. But can we shame her for it? She's setting a standard for a lot of people in the culture. And if her husband's okay with it, then I'm not judging.
Her husband's a simp.
Oh. Yo, say that shit, Brian.
But that's her husband.
Everybody know Russell don't got no backbone. So,
and it's a cultural norm. And Ciara's known for her dancing, you know?
Uh-huh. But she's married now. She was known for her dancing. Goodies came out in 2002. Right? When she was dressed like when she was built like a small forward. So should a woman married or spoken for be twerking for the gram or other people? Key with the thing.
Should a woman who's married or spoken for be twerking for the gram?
Hell no. Hell
what kind
no.
of shit is that? You're basically representing your husband, and you're, you know what I'm saying? And then she got kids. Like, the fuck? That shit look crazy.
She got a daughter.
That looks crazy. And that's coming from somebody who I've posted several videos of my workout progression, you know, showing my abdomen and whatnot. But it's like, there's a time and a place for everything. And unless I'm literally like on some personal trainer shit at this point, yeah, when I was single, I was doing a lot more that I looked like thirst trapping. But unless there's a purpose for it within that marriage, you look fucking crazy. You're disrespecting your husband and you're disrespecting yourself in a sense. So, no.
Alex?
I agree with everybody so far. Married, you ain't got no business doing that. But again, to the shame point, if Russell did say something, then people would get on him. They'd be like, you're shaming your wife for her expression, and she should be able to do this, she should be able to do that. For me, who are married, I don't think you need to be doing none of that. You're a mother. Don't do that. Don't do that shit.
Sean?
It's a bad example, but I'm confused, and maybe I need some clarity, because I agree with everybody saying, but is it a difference for Beyonce who does it on the stage performing? Like, where's is there a double standard? Is it okay on one end? Is it not on the other end? You know, I may need some clarity, but I'm agreeing with everybody. I think is uncalled for, and it's a bad example because of her celebrity status, and because she's married, and they represent what, you know, both of them talk is as a Christian household.
Okay, yeah. So I'm processing information of Beyonce. I feel like when I watch her show, it doesn't come across like the last Super Bowl. I think there's some provocative moves, but it doesn't seem the same. Like, I don't know. It just it's
tasteful.
Yeah, it's because it's not like she's twerk. Like is she standing there actually twerking and only twerking, like, or is it a move and then it goes into something else?
We're talking about Beyonce who got the leotard onesie on every performance with the legs out, butt out, that Beyonce?
Yeah, that one.
You know what it could be, Sean? It could be that Ciara almost over-publicized her marriage as opposed to Beyonce, who kept that professionalism as far as her career. Like, even with Destiny's Child, they were showing a lot of skin. So it's almost like Beyonce never really changed as much. We knew she was married to Jay-Z, obviously, and then they made songs together. I think Ciara kind of goes back and forth where with Russell, she portrays this wholesome marriage lifestyle and then dips back into who we know her as. So that could have something to do.
So is it because she's married to a square that we look at it different?
Well, she the one putting all them Christmas pictures and all that good wholesome shit out there. We not.
I mean, I agree. You hear her say, you know, Russell Wilson saved her life. God saved them. God saved their marriage. They, you know, the holier than thou, the whole thing, the whole spiel. But we don't hold Beyonce to the same standard. You know what I mean? Like, who is it? Where's the guideline? If it's a bad example for Ciara to do it, isn't it the same? Even though Beyonce's on the stage performing, you don't see Beyonce in like the backyard doing it or doing the latest challenge dance or TikTok, whatever that Ciara does. Beyonce's doing it in a more professional manner because she's working, you know.
But I think with Ciara, it's one of those things where it's just like, who asked you for that, sis? Nobody asked you that. You have a few songs coming out. Is this part of your music video? If not, who asked you for it? Versus with Beyonce, same point, like, it's performative. That's her job. She's always done that kind of music. She's always had that type of performance. Versus Ciara, like, everybody was minding their good business, and you just took it upon yourself to join in on the challenge and do that. Nobody asked you to do that.
Question, Alex.
Right.
Did nobody not ask her or ask her? I'm just wondering, man. I get thrown off, you know?
Cut it out.
You're talking like a fifth grader. All right, Brian.
So there's a double standard.
Yeah, there's a double standard. Let B, what you feel? Yeah. I know you already yelled out that it was a simp.
Yes.
No, I mean, I agree with everyone on the podcast. I think it was wonderful feedback. What I do look at is, and it goes back to taking Beyonce and Ciara out of it, still the twerking, like, if you're in a public place, I don't understand why a woman feels the need to just start twerking. I'm still stuck on that part. I don't know where that comes from. I don't know what would resonate in a woman's mind that, oh, I'm in public, let me start twerking. I just don't know where that comes from. But nonetheless, to answer your question, I think that the feedback was wonderful. I agree with it all. Nothing I have to add nor take away.
Yeah. It's just odd. And then she had no shirt on, right? Like, it's a whole thing for me. You can't even, like, there's no panty line. Like, her skirt dress thing was, like, half cocked so you could see, like, the side of her ass cheek. That's somebody's wife.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And the fact that he would allow that.
And because they always reference Christianity and such, the Bible says on one particular point, you shouldn't even go to the bar with another man's wife. Like, it literally said, like, there's certain things, like, when it comes to another man's wife, you refrain and stay away from. Right. You know what I'm saying? And now his wife is on the gram for everybody to see. It just is very, I don't know, it's contrary, right? Because they referenced that so much.
I think she's just really trying to stay relevant.
Yes, because no one is checking for her at all.
But would you gonna sell your soul to stay relevant?
Many entertainers do.
Yeah, I mean, I have seen a lot of black men put dresses on and shit like that. You know, it's just a shame.
A man should not wear women's clothing.
So we're gonna compare her to Beyonce. Beyonce doesn't have to stay relevant. She can do that and at her performances. People are still gonna follow her. Like you said, who's checking for Ciara?
Well, it's a clear double standard. I mean, Cardi B's a married woman too.
Yeah, I agree with Sean in a sense. There is just something that makes it double standardish. Like even as I'm thinking about the way that video looked, I could totally picture Beyonce doing something similar. I mean, obviously I don't see her doing it topless and her having her two kids, but it just looked so thirst trappish coming from Ciara. I don't know. It doesn't work for me.
If it was Beyonce, it would be in a commercial, right? For Tiffany. You know what I'm saying?
Because that's how she's getting her coin. But Ciara is just like, okay, there was no purpose.
That's what I'm saying. Like she woke up and said, you know what, this is what I'm gonna do today.
Yeah. And I don't think she has any music coming out or movies or anything. Like
what was your purpose? And with Cardi B, she's always portraying her image. So married or not, she's still going to be her. But Ciara, maybe because I just don't care for Ciara. It's just always gonna be a no in my book.
It's always gonna boil down to what you got a flavor for the person for. Like if you don't fool with the person like that, then it's always gonna be a problem.
Yeah.
We make no fuss about other celebrity wives who do crazy stuff on Bad Girls Club or Housewives or whatever. These are married women that don't adhere to a certain standard that we will deem respectful or honorable. But it's still, we don't make any fuss about it. You know what I mean? We hold certain people to a higher standard, and we probably hold Ciara to a higher standard because of her relationship with her husband and because of what they put out. They put out that they are of God and, you know, moving through the word and God saved them together. You know what I mean? We don't hold everybody else to the same standard.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's what it is. When they rope in, you know, the Most High or whatever you want to call it, I think that's what resets the precedence for them and the standards that they are held to. Yeah. You know, and I think that
Obama jumped out and started twerking. Yeah. We everybody lose their mind. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. People lose their mind.
Yeah. And I think Russ, I think there's a very valid point. He's so fucking square. Mm-hmm. That it's almost like we almost think Ciara taking advantage of him. Like it's like he's trying to grab her before she walked out there, but she just shrugged the nigga off.
But the two of them make one another look good. They benefit one another by being together.
They do?
In the public eye, yes. No,
Ciara gave Russ street cred.
And he makes her look like a good girl.
Right.
Yeah,
because you went from Future to Russell Wilson. I don't know. You had 50 Cent, you had Bow Wow, you had Future, and now you're with Russell. Like
Ciara made Russ cool. Mm-hmm. His hairstyle's different. He's dressed different. She made him cool. He's still not that cool. He's still kind of corny, but she made him cool.
And he made her wholesome.
So would we see that the same way if she was doing that and she was married to Future?
No, we wouldn't have a problem with it.
It would make more sense, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, see, that's where I think the double standard lies. It's like, Jay-Z so hood, like, Beyonce could just perform how she do. And like I said, she's been so consistent with it that it doesn't feel the same. But that whole Ciara shit, she need to pack that up. That should just look inappropriate. It looked like she violating her husband.
She just put a prayer on Summer Walker's album. So, like, you're twerking and praying?
Mm. Oh, I remember that. I like Summer Walker, but I just never seen Beyonce just flat out just do like just the twerk session though.
Right. Yeah.
Not posting like that's the point. Yeah.
cool. Because she doesn't need the attention like that, though.
Oh yeah, let's make no mistake. I believe that she does. They're just a lot more private, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, she probably twerked for him, but that's the point, right? Like,
wait, why do you believe that she does?
Why? Mm-hmm. Because it's something she's good at. Most people don't stop doing things that they're not good at, right?
And guess twerking is normal. Like, we've normalized twerking. That's why.
He's trying to bring it back full circle.
It's a regular two-step now. She's right. It's a regular two-step now.
Yeah.
I mean, there's derivatives from how we dance, too. You know what I mean? So, I don't know if it's like a new thing, but it has a new name, and it's done in a way. It's been portrayed in a way and used in a way where women were, what's the word? Objectified. Mm-hmm. Right? And twerking is kind of how they get highlighted, you know? There was a comment earlier about how a lot of these women that's twerking on the gram, they get married, and that's how their husbands found them. I beg to say that the women twerking on the gram ain't married either. You know what I mean? You know what? There was our Jasmine Cashmere who got married, but by and large, them hoes stay single. Right? So I would
agree with that, because you're not going to marry a woman, even if she was doing that when you met her or when you found her.
Right.
You marry her. Like, that's not going to continue.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know, man. I think she.
That would be like considered like a wine. Like, that's just me being hung up on the word, but that wasn't twerking.
But the ass pop is the twerk part, and then there was a wine too. See, when a nigga can dance, they can do everything at once. He can dance so. You were doing both, like, you know what I mean? Like,
dancing no seductively, question. Whatever.
Yeah, and provocatively, right? You know how many, and that's the thing, that's somebody's wife. Do you know how many niggas that are listening doing that? You know how many times they were around that 38-second video? Just to rub one out? I'm telling you, I don't know. I think about all, like... That's somebody's wife. Like, come on, man.
Put him in the fucking bedroom. Get him out of here. Come on,
man. You
know? So, I don't know, man. Ciara, we understand that you're not relevant anymore. Matter of fact, hold on, let me just.
Oh, I disagree, though. She is relevant.
She is?
She was at the Met Gala with the big green dress on. Like,
and she's with Russell Wilson, and they benefit one another.
Yeah. I wouldn't say that she's irrelevant. We always see her. Every 3-4 months, she's popping up on something, dancing or in a gown somewhere. She ain't irrelevant.
Because of her husband.
I mean, yeah.
I don't think it's because of her talents. Like, singing is not for singing anymore.
No, I don't think that matters, though. There's a lot of people who are in the public spotlight who don't have a talent. So and she actually has one and doesn't use it.
Clarification. In terms of music, art, her relevancy is, we're not looking for her music, her next release, her next album. I think she's relevant in terms of people know who she is. She may even have some sway, right? Especially when people say, pray her prayer or something of that nature, right? The Ciara prayer. So she is relevant in that, but largely because of her husband. But in terms of what we knew her for, that's a thing that people may see her and only know her for Russ, especially Generation Z, right? Do they know goodies? Like, do they know how well she used to dance? You know, I don't know if they know all of that. You know, even like John Madden, you know, God bless the dead. A lot of kids know him for the video game. They don't know he was a Super Bowl winning coach. Mm-hmm. You know, so I think because time has passed, so now you are what you are based on what people know now, based on what you're doing. So awesome, 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 awesome. I just want to share this one more time because for anybody who thinks this is cool and you think that it's okay to do, this is how we see you guys. All right. Nobody Nobody is checking for the bonnet brigade. You know what I mean? I don't care if you're going to the store or what. So shout out to Nori for being
there. Shout out to Nori.
All right. Don't do it.